Hi folks, Jeremy Schaefer here. Today I'm going to show you how to fold this heart from a sheet of printer paper that was cut square. And what's cool about it is that it balances on this pyramid and it spins. If you'd like to learn how to fold the pyramid, click here. I'm going to now show you how to fold the heart. Ready, set, here we go. All right, so for this model, we're going to use a sheet of printer paper cut square. So in order to cut it square, we're going to take this short edge and fold right up to the long edge. If you already have a square sheet of paper, then click here for the beginning of the tutorial. All right, so we're folding it up right like this and crease all the way across. And now let's turn over right to left and rotate 90 degrees. And now let's take this short edge and fold it up. How far? We're going to fold it right to this edge. And we're going to fold on that edge and crease very sharply and unfold and turn over and unfold. And let's reverse this crease a few times just to make sure that it's nice and loose. Okay, crease it very sharply. And, well, if you want, you could just cut it off, but I like tearing it off, I think it's easier. All right, so what you do is you want to make a tiny tear right at the top here, and you want to push the paper together so it makes a ridge right like this, and now we're just going to separate our hands like this and tear all the way down and try to separate evenly on both sides. Tears right down the crease. Like that. All right. What model are we gonna make? All right, so now we're ready to make the heart. So if you're using Kami, begin white side up and let's valley fold diagonally in half and unfold. And let's fold diagonally in half in this direction. Okay, now we have to divide this side into thirds. So let's fold it over. We're just going to pinch right on the edge. Don't actually fold it over. And let's fold this behind. And now we just have to fiddle with these folds to make sure that they line up. So I see this one needs to be pushed over. I'm gonna push it past here. I'm gonna pull this back and just fiddle with the folds until they're perfect thirds. And just pinch right here, like that. All right, so we have our thirds pinched. Now we're going to take this flap and fold it up right on our pinch mark and make sure that it lands right on this edge and flatten. And let's do the same thing on the left side. So fold this up right on this pinch mark and make sure that the point lands on this edge. And crease, and now let's rotate 180 degrees, and let's fold this corner up like this, and let's fold this corner up and unfold them. And now let's rotate and let's fold this corner right up to the other end of the crease, so right to there. And let's rotate 90 degrees and let's fold this corner up to there. And now let's fold this triangle, this flap, right over like that and unfold. And let's stick it into one of these pockets. We have three options. Let's choose, might as well choose the top one, just so that we have less layer showing, although that's the hardest one. Okay, just like that. And let's do the same thing on this side. So let's fold this corner to this point right here. Let's fold this corner up and fold the triangular flap over and open up the pocket. It doesn't really matter which one, but I'm choosing the top pocket so that we only have one edge showing. Okay. So just like that. And now let's fold it in half like this. And unfold and flatten it out. And now it's time to balance it on a point. So let's turn it over and we're going to balance it on this pencil. So let's put the heart onto the pencil right on this edge and just slide it left and right until you find the center of balance. And once you find the point where this line is level, then just take two fingers, one on either side of the pencil. Here's the pencil point. We're just going to press down right on that point and just make that little pinch crease right here. This is the center of balance. Okay, so now let's mount and fold in half. And we're going to reverse fold this flap, but first let's valley fold it. And let's valley fold it about like this. I don't really have a guideline for it, but the important part is that we want it to come to a point right at our center of gravity crease mark. So, yeah, just fold it about like that. If you want a bigger crevice, then you'll fold it a little bit more, but this is about a good crevice, I think. Okay, so that's our valley fold. Now we're going to reverse fold it. So let's open it up. And here we have, on the left, a mountain fold. That's good. This is a valley fold, but it needs to be a mountain fold. So let's reverse it like that. And the fold in between is a valley. So just like that. Okay, let's open it up. And let's take this flap and let's fold it over to the left. Let's rotate. Or let's fold it to the right. Okay, you know what I mean. Now we're going to fold this corner to the crease right here, and we're going to fold it right like this. So the crease crosses this middle crease right here. So we fold it right like that so that the point lands on the crease, and we're going to squash right here. Just that. And hopefully these will be somewhat even. And that is the crevice in the heart. Voila! And now our model is ready to balance again. Alright, so you might have to adjust the reverse fold. Like this one seems to be balancing a little bit to the left, so that means that I need to push the center of gravity to the left so that it'll balance more to the right. So I'm gonna just go like this a little tiny bit. I think the center of gravity changed because we made these folds. Okay, and there. I'm going to say this is the center of gravity. Let's see. Yeah, that's much better. Okay, and let's see if it spins. It does. Alright, so there's spinning on a pencil, and it can also be spun on a pyramid. And if you'd like to fold the pyramid, then click here. Alright, well I hope you guys enjoyed folding this balancing spinning heart, and see you later!